There was a black woman that had a YouTube video out where she was beating her 60-year-old daughter. Did you guys see that? We have it up on our site at rebuildingtheman.com. And she was like pounding her and just smacking her upside the head and hit her in the ear and just really punching her in the stomach while at the same time cursing her out, calling her T-H-O-T. Do you know what that is? You never heard of her. A thought is a whore. That's a new word for whore. The problem is the mother, the girl is just like the mother. The mother had on these little hot pants all up here, little pink hot pants and some of the halter top thing on, looking worse than her daughter. And she gonna beat the daughter for being out of control. She was saying, "You are embarrassing me." Can you imagine having a mother like that as a child? And your mother show up at school or something looking like that? And then the mother would get in front of the mirror and do her hair all up. The daughter is just like the mother. But the mother doesn't see that in herself. And she's trying to make the daughter do something that she's not doing. You know, last Sunday we talked about parents don't cause your kids to resent. Well, when you're mean like that with your kids, when you're impatient with your kids, when you whoop your kids with anger, then you are causing them to resent. I realized from that the reason that a lot of black men and women are so traumatized is because their mothers and grandmothers whooped them and smacked them upside the head while growing up with the intent, some of them, to make them better people. But they did it with the spirit of anger, which is hatred. And then they'll use the scripture where the Bible said, train a child up, no, spare the rod and spoil the child, something like that, right? But the Bible was not talking about angry parents beating and correcting their children. An angry parent cannot correct a child. You have no love. There's no love in anger. And so you're trying to correct the child. You're correcting them with anger. And then so you end up messing the kids up and you wonder what happened to them. But I noticed that with white mothers, they tend to not whoop their kids or spank their kids. Sometimes they do. But they tend to be very impatient with their kids. You know, like, I told you to sit down. Mommy is not going to put up with this anymore. That kind of stuff. But that's still anger. And with that anger, it still corrupts the child. Because there is no love in anger. Every human being who has anger lack love. Absolutely have no love. That's why we have to get over it, because you cause your kids, you traumatize your kids. A lot of parents, they mean well. They don't mean to mess up the kids. They want what's best, but they're correcting you with the wrong spirit. And that's why you end up, you know, they end up messed up, even though you're trying to do what's right for them.
I remember one time when my mom, she caught me and she had like one of the big worker wooden things.
I swear.
And she used to whoop me and my brother with it. She whooped us both at the same time because it was like real long. She was like,
wow. How old were you at the time?
About like 7.
You were 7 years old? How old do you know?
9.
9. Wow. And that hurt, huh? I can't hear you.
Yeah, it hurt.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's done with anger. That's what the problem is. You must forgive so that you can operate from the right spirit. But that mother, that woman need to be put in jail. She really does. She fought her daughter like a ghetto child. Like she would fight somebody in the hood, another woman in the hood. She looked like a hood rat. We want her daughter to be something else. And her daughter said that she was about to tell her mother that she was having sex. She wanted to tell her, but she couldn't find a way to tell her. Also, they had to end up going to the hospital. And the daughter later wrote that she went to the hospital because she was having anxiety attacks and headaches. And I'm imagining, can you imagine being raised by a woman like that? And so now, as a young girl, she's already having these anxiety attacks, and she's going to be on medication. and all that kind of madness for the rest of her life. Unless someone comes along and says to her, you need to forgive your mother. She's insane. She is of her father, the devil, but you need to forgive her so you can overcome that. And she's not going to, it's rare. I hope I'm wrong, but she's not going to hear that. They're going to blame it on racism. They're going to blame it on poverty. They're going to blame it on the man. Everybody but the mother. Our battle is a spiritual battle. It's a warfare between good and evil all the time. And of ourselves, we know nothing, and of ourselves, we can do nothing. And one thing I've noticed about evil, it takes everything that we hear and learn and use it against us to deceive us, to make us think that we have something that we don't have. It'll imitate whatever the Bible says, whatever God is. Evil imitates that and presents itself as God. And when you are born again of God, when you repent, when you forgive and you enter into the kingdom of heaven within, you are now developing a new nature in God, right? And one aspect of that is that you start to recognize God's voice. He said, my children shall know me by my voice. And then so Satan's voice, the one that we were talking about, that's always bringing the doubt, he's lying to you one way or another, we start to get away from that and become a distant from us. And so it can't manipulate and control us like it did prior to entering into the kingdom of heaven. And then, but once you enter in, then you start growing spiritually. It's like a little baby that's born, start to grow and discover. And so your conversation about things, it go beyond, well, I'm just riding down the road and I saw this and I came back into the present. That's like an introduction of what happens, but it's not the meat of what's happening at all. It's like when you sit to pray, the prayer is not the thing you should be focused on. It's the growth that comes as a result of that. And I noticed a lot of people, it's just the same old story all the time. They never get past. It's like they're not growing as children of God. It's so much more than just waiting to confront someone or having the right words to say or just being in the present and all that. And for some reason, the mind is still playing the trick. And the one thing that Satan is good at, he's real good at imitating God, very good at that. He'll quote you the scriptures. He'll make you see things that's not there. He'll convince you that right is wrong, wrong is right. He'll build you up and tear you down. He can cause you to become afraid. He can cause you to be happy and cause you to be sad, have fear. He can do all that stuff to you. And none of those things God does to you. None of those things. Not one iota of what I just said involved in being a child of God. Because when you come into that place where he is within, you have perfect peace all the time. You're not going to this, you grow. And I don't feel like people are growing. And I think it's because it just learns stuff. And there are so many people, every angry person is still living and controlled by their imagination. Because Satan live off your anger, that's why he doesn't want you to forgive. So even when I say forgive, you know, for the last 26 years, I've been trying to help black men and women get all people really, but especially blacks, to get over there, to know themselves, take control of their lives by forgiving their parents and forgiving white people, stop hating themselves. You know, they say, oh, you just Uncle Tom. You just this. They won't even accept the word forgiveness nowadays because Satan, their father, will not let them. They literally think that our problem is a physical problem. It has something to do with color, and it has nothing to do with that at all. It has everything to do with being angry first at your parents and then at yourself and the world around you.